Kill like James Bond. I don't give a fuck. I got that on like John Wick. Run up in the cut with that new switch. Like he a kid, like he on punishment. Chopper put his ass out, lay him down on the bed. That's all I got right now.
My mother with me and then spinning me around. from the very start. Deep down, in your heart.
Hey, happy Father's Day.
And that's the
happy
way it
Father's
is.
Day.
Yes, 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 yes. Yeah. Yeah, we are one. In a community, that's the way it should be.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's right, we are one.
That's right. Happy Father's Day.
That's right, happy Father's Day. That's right, we are one.
We are one.
We are one. That's right, upright, independent, and fearless. We are one. And that's the way it motherfucking is. We are one.
If I was just another person, would you blow me off and play me like everybody else? If I asked you to strike the back, could you manage that? Thank you, you can travel, I can handle that. Furthermore, I apologize for any of the cracks. It's just the last girl to play me left a couple cracks. I used to, now I'm over that. Cause holding grudges over lovers ain't your artifacts. If I could only find a note to make you understand, I sing a song in the ear and grab your brother hands.
An old school 50-pound boombox. Would you have me on your shoulder wherever you want? Would you turn my volume up in front of the cops and crank it higher every time you told you to stop? And all I ask is that you don't get mad at me. We got the purpose, man. Appreciate every mixtape your friends make. You never know, we come and go like on the interstate. I think you probably find another to make you understand. If you can hear this, say the longer, take me by the hands. Keep the stuff you sound like your favorite tune.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Channel Excellence, where we strive for excellence. We strive to be one better than what we were yesterday. Why? Because some of the things in my life was just jacked up. You know, when you live the life that I live and half of your life has just been jacked up and just screwed all the way up, and everything you did, you thought was right, was just jacked up, and you just got to the point where you was just fed up with being jacked up and jacked up with being fed up, you know, and your fucked up was just fucked up and it was fucked up. And until you got to the point where you just couldn't do nothing but get fucked up, and then something happens till you get to that point where you just snap and say enough is enough. I got to do something about this ratchet, raggedy-ass life of mine. I ain't going nowhere with this. I'm just ain't shit. I mean, I'm just fucking up, and my fucked up is fucked up, and it's fucked up. And everything I do, I just fuck it up. And don't nobody want to deal with you because you're just fucked up and you fuck shit up. But then it comes to a point where you got to do a 360 and turn around and undo some of that fucked up shit. Well, when you've been beat, battered, broken, drugged through the mud, and I'll be damn, I don't know what the hell else y'all can put me through. I mean, I done been through it all. I mean, from death to destruction to dealing with you motherfuckers. And I still gotta deal with more shit. When is this gonna ever end? And the goodness begin? At some point in my life, I got to seek for some type of peace, some type of happiness, something. You know what I mean? There's nothing but love in my heart. But this world is tearing this motherfucker apart. How could you deal with it? The trials, the tribulations is to make you stronger so you can go through more trials and tribulations and this shit lasts longer. Well, it's gonna end soon. Because I realize one thing, that every individual on this earth is here to do what no man has never done before. And everything that you do, nobody else can do it. Nobody has ever done it. So let's see what you can do that nobody else in this world has ever done. Because I'm going to do something. And I'm on my mission to do what no man has ever done. And that's live in peace. With myself, with my surroundings, and with everyone. I don't give a rat's ass about how you choose to live or think about me. That ain't got nothing to do with me. Nothing. Nothing. My thoughts, my thinking, my reasoning, my willing, and my understanding comes from a divine place of existence. Divinely prepared. So if I talk to you in a divine measure and you can't meet it, it was not for your pleasure. So keep it moving and don't stop and fake fuck with me. Because I'm going to tell you what I want and how I want it. Because you have not, because you ask not. And you want not. And when you ask for what you want, you will get. So it's no problem with being real and keeping it 100 with everybody. Because I'm not going to sugarcoat shit for nobody. Once you know the truth, it's up to you to live in the truth or live in a lie. And if you want to meet me with your truth and my truth, then we're going to be the truth together. And see, that's when you talk about true religion. It's to live in spirit with one another. See, that's the greatness for all of us. to learn to love instead of hate. Love your brothers, treat them like an equal. They call us animals, I don't agree with them. I prove them wrong, but right is what you're proving them. I mean the children, let's look at our children. Our children is supposed to be our future. But how can we have a future if the mother of them children is teaching them how to shoot you? How could I have a future if the mother of the children that I bought ice creams for is trying to teach their children how to shoot me? See, all you mothers of the world that's out there fighting and battling with your children, what are you doing? Wait a minute. Is there any adult in the home? Or are there still children that are raising children? I mean, is anyone over 21 that they can say that they are a grown-up, they grew up? I mean, grown-ups grow up. They think, reason, will, and understand in a mature manner. They communicate to one and other with the utmost intelligence for reason and resolution and not chaos and confusion. So when you can raise your thoughts to that infinite wisdom of love and unconditional love for one another, that's when you will shine in your greatness. We're here to love, not hate. What does hate breed? Nothing. You will not eat an apple off a rotten tree. But yet and still, we are the tree that breeds the fruit of love to one another. Have you ever seen an orange tree eat an orange? Have you ever seen a banana tree eat a banana? Have you ever seen an apple tree eat an apple? Or a grapevine eat a grape? But yet they are deeply rooted into the soil of soul so that they can grow apace and stay rooted in the earth. See, all of those essential plants bear fruit for the living. They bear fruit for giving. Once you learn to bear your fruit for the living, all your sins can be forgiven and you can start living. I come to y'all in love, I leave y'all in peace. Do not wait to think about what I said when you deceased. Come on.
Everybody in this room wants two things. Everybody wants to be successful and everybody wants to be happy. But I'm going to tell you what you're going to have to do. You're going to change your mindset. I ain't got no more than none of y'all got. God gave me the same thing he gave y'all. He don't love me more than he love you. But you have got to change your mindset. If you think that they're going to mail this money to your house, you're dead wrong about that. If you want to be successful, you got to change your mind and you're going to have some faith.
My mentor said, learn to work harder on yourself than you do on your job. I got the message. Then he added, if you work hard on your job, you can make a living. If you work hard on yourself, you could make a fortune. I had never heard that kind of philosophy before. He said, success is something you attract by the person you become. Success is not something you pursue. Success is something you develop, something you become. You attract success. To attract attractive people, you must be attractive. To attract committed people, you must be committed. So the whole key to unlock all the treasures is by your own personal development. And then he added one more, which is so important. Here it is. What you become is much more valuable than what you get. The major question to ask on the job is not, what am I getting here? The major question to ask on the job is, what am I becoming here? Because what you become attracts. If you become cynical, you attract cynicism. So this whole subject of personal development was so vitally important to me. I was a millionaire by age 31. And that was just the economic part of it. It was unbelievable.
To me, success is like knowing the combination to a lock. If you know the combination to a lock, it doesn't matter if you're male or female, you're 55 or you're 16, your IQ is 150 or your IQ is 93. And the problem is, most of us are going through life and we don't know the combination. And if you know a system always produces a predictable result. And so I want to share with you the basics of a system that works no matter what you're starting out at, wherever you are. It will work for you. Now, the promise I always make people is threefold. If you do this work and you apply it to your life, and the key is apply it, not just listen to it. Now, Jim Rohn says you can't hire other people to do your push-ups for you. I love that quote. There are things that no one else can do for you. So the first principle building on that says you must take 100% responsibility for your life and your results. And what that means is you have to give up all blaming, all looking out at the world and saying, well, if the world were different, then I would be better off. We go through all these things where we say, if it wasn't for that, if it wasn't for the war, if it wasn't for him, if it wasn't for her, then my life would be working perfectly. But there's a little formula I learned. It says E plus R equals O. And what that stands for are the events in your life, you have a response to them, and that creates outcomes. For example, if I put $200 in front of you and you go out and party with it, but if I put that $200 in front of you, that's the event, your response is you invested, so now your net worth went up. Same event, different responses. Basically, it's not what people say to you. It's not what they do to you. And if you want a different outcome, because E plus R equals O is like 2 plus 2 equals 4, responsibility means you have the ability to change your response to something other than what you're currently doing. So basically, we are responsible to change our behavior until we get the outcomes we want. I want to give you a business example. A friend of mine during the first Gulf War was a Lexus dealer, and people stopped coming in to buy Lexuses. They were all watching CNN and CNBC, and plus we were having a minor recession, so people were holding on to their discretionary income. He said to his staff, E plus R equals O. There's a war. Our response is we've been doing the same thing. We better do something different. So they tried four things. They said, if the people aren't coming to us, let's take cars to where they are. So they would go out with 5 or 6 Lexuses, and they'd go to a party. They'd go up and say, Tom, what do you do for a living? And then I would say, have you ever driven a Lexus? You know, we have a new LS400 outside, never been ridden by anyone. It's got the new seats that have the air that comes out that can keep you warm or keep you hot. Would you like to take a little spin with me, see what it's like? Now, you come back in. Let me ask you a question. How many of you have ever test driven a new luxury car and then got back in your old car? Well, they ended up selling over 60% of the people they did that with a new car within 2 weeks. And if you keep experimenting like that, you'll find the R that works, but you have to be willing to take a risk. And the reason most of us don't do that is we don't want to feel uncomfortable, because all new things require discomfort. Now, most of you remember learning to drive a car. But after a couple months, you're there driving with your knee, you got a Big Mac in your left hand, you're breaking up a fight in the back seat with the kids with your right hand. But you have to be willing to go through that awkward, uncomfortable stage. So what I want you to do is to realize that life is an experiment. You have lots of responses that are possible. So there's three kinds of responses. Number one is your behavior. Number two is your thoughts. Number three is the images you hold in your head. What you say and do, the thoughts you think, and the imageries that you hold inside your head. When you say, I can't, when you focus on your failures instead of your successes, and when you surround yourself with people who are judgmental rather than encouraging and empowering, it actually has a physical effect on you. So we have to be very careful where we place ourselves and who we hang out with and who we surround ourselves with. And one of the principles here is you have to eliminate the phrase, I can't, from your vocabulary. I'll try. Those are all ways of saying I'm not capable. Henry Ford said, whether you think you can or think you can't, either way, you're right. Because if you think you can, you will try. And if you try, you're probably going to pull it off. And if you think you can't, you won't. And if you don't try, then you're not going to get it done at all. Make sense? I can tell you story after story. I met a kid named Kyle Maynard last year. He has no legs past the knees. He was the number two wrestler in the state of Georgia his senior year in high school. Can type 150 words a minute with the stubs of his arms. When I hear that and I look at these people, I think, what's my excuse? There's nothing you can't do. And all those people that are out there that are doing anything that you go, wow, that's great, is just a model. It says this is possible, and if they can do it, I can do it. Now, another principle is you've got to surround yourself with positive people. Jim Rohn said again, you're the average of the five people you spend the most time with. If your friends are victims and their lives aren't working and their marriages don't work and they're not making money, that's a reflection back. And what I teach people is always try to get with the people that are the next level up. Get in their space, learn what they do, how they think, etc. General Wesley Clark, who I interviewed, said it doesn't take any more effort to dream a big dream than it takes to dream a small dream. Most people hone down their dream because they can't see how they can do it. Dream as big as you want. Big dreams are exciting. Big dreams attract big people. Walt Disney said, if you can dream it, you can do it. You may have to learn some new skills. You may have to partner up with some people. But all of that is possible if you'll simply dream the big dream. Does that make sense? So trust your dreams.
Here's what I realize, that if you're not willing to take a chance on you and reach beyond your comfort zone, you never discover the greatness that you have within yourself to experience more. Do something beyond your comfort zone. Learn something new so you can see what's in you. So you want to maximize this time. You want to make your move right now. If you're not willing to learn anything new, no one can help you. But if you're willing to learn something new, no one can stop you. So the people that are going to come out on top, they're hungry. Most people are conditioned to do just enough to keep from getting fired, where they've been paid just enough to keep from quitting. You got to be hungry. You have to get your stuff together. Doing just enough to get by? No. Can be mastered if you're willing to put in the time. and focus yourself on learning how to do that to make yourself stand out. Do not go where the path may lead. Go where there's no path and leave a trail.
I want you to max out your life. I want you to max out your business. See, you were made to do something great with your life. Every single day has to be a pursuit to get better, to grow. You got to get a little bit more intense. You got to stop being so dadgum casual.
Welcome to the channel, Excellantz'. Well, we do everything live, but we're gonna do it to you live today. And I said the very next time I'm falling in love, the lady, I mean, she has to be my friend. The very first time I saw your brown eyes, yeah, I said hello, and I said, I never knew you were the one. But I was caught up in physical attraction, but to my satisfaction, maybe you were more than just a face. And if I am
she will be my friend.